Hello everyone, myself Dr. Dharitri Borgohain, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, North Lakhimpur College. Today, I am going to discuss a very interesting topic, that is hybrid varieties of plants. Before moving on to the topic, I would like to give an overview of the whole topic. That is, what is meant by hybridization, what are its different objectives, what are the different types of hybridization, and the different hybrid varieties of plants that have been developed so far. Now, this hybridization, it is considered as an important method of combining characters of two different plants. The production of a hybrid by crossing two individuals of unlike genetic constitution is known as hybridization. It does not change the genetic contents of the organisms but produces new combination of genes. This hybridization process, it is more common in plants than animals. It is mainly done by crossing of plants to get useful traits such as resistance to pest and disease, better yield, taste, etc. Nowadays, this hybridization process has become the key method of crop improvement and a vast variety of crop varieties have resulted out of it. The different objectives of hybridization. Firstly, to artificially create a variable population for the selection of types with desired combination of characters. Secondly, to exploit and utilize the hybrid varieties, to combine the desired characters into a single individual. Now moving on to the next slide, what are the different types of hybridization? Broadly, hybridization can be classified into three main types. One is the intra-varietal hybridization. It is the crossing between plants of same variety. Next one, it is the intervarietal or intraspecific hybridization. This hybridization refers to crossing of two different varieties. Third one, it is the intrageneric or intraspecific hybridization. It refers to the crossing between two different species of the same genus. Now moving on to the next slide. What are the different hybrid varieties of plants that have been developed through hybridization? First one, it is the pomato. It is a hybrid variety of potato and tomato. It is a small tomato-like fruit with white flesh, edible either raw or cooked. This pomato plant produces tomatoes on top and potatoes underground. Next one, it is the Olympia. It is a hybrid variety of spinach, which is highly preferred due to its superior growth. The leaves of Olympia are dark green in color, quite thick, and their growth is upright. This hybrid spinach is highly resistant to bolting under summer temperature and long days. Next, we move on to the early sunglow corn. It is a hybrid of sweet corn. The vast majority of US corn grown are hybrid varieties. This early sun glow corn, it is considered as one of the best varieties of sweet corn for home gardens. It is mostly known for its sweetness, flavor and tenderness. Next one is the hybrid lilies. We can classify the hybrid lilies into two main types. One is the Asiatic hybrid lilies and another one, it is the Oriental hybrid lilies. These Asiatic hybrid lilies, they have small flowers and their flowers come in bright shades of either yellow, gold, pink, white or orange. These Asiatic hybrid lilies, they bear no fragments. Whereas the Oriental lilies, they have large flowers. Their color ranges from pink, red, purple and white. They have fragments. Next one, it is the Meyer lemons. These Meyer lemons, it is the cross between true lemon tree and mandarin orange. The fruit of Meyer lemon is much sweeter in taste compared to that of the normal lemons. Next one, it is the Better Boys tomato. It is quite resistant to Fusarium wilt and nematodes. These two are the common tomato problems. It causes huge loss to that of the tomato cultivars. Next one, it is the Argemon mexicana. It is a species of poppy which is found in Mexico. It is highly poisonous to grazing animals, so rarely it is being eaten. Tolerant to poor soil as well as drought conditions, the Mexicana seeds, it contains 22 to 36% of a pale yellow, non-edible oil, which is known as Katkar oil or Argemon oil. and it contains an alkaloid. It possesses bright yellow latex and has medicinal importance too. Next one, it is a triticale. This triticale is a man-made cereal crop, and it is the product of a cross between wheat and rye plant. Here we have seen that a triticum durum and sickle cereal, wheat and rye, they are crossed to obtain the triticale, that is hexaploid. And this triticale has certain beneficial effects, such as it is highly beneficial in managing diabetes. It also helps in increasing cell production in the body. It protects infant against neural tube defect. This triticale, it boosts bone growth and prevents conditions like osteoporosis. It reduces the risk of asthma and various skin conditions. It helps to improve metabolic efficiency as well as hair growth. And it is a product of hybridization. Next one is the Afano brassica. It is the cross between radish as well as cabbage. But this Afano brassica, it turned out to be an unfruitful one because the desired traits were not obtained as a result of hybridization. These are references from where I have taken help in preparing the whole presentation. Thank you all for your patience.